On May 18, 1941, when King had snuck away from the studying at home to watch a parade, King was informed that something had happened to his maternal grandmother. Upon returning home, he found out that she had suffered a heart attack and died while being transported to hospital. He took the death very hard and believed that his deception of going to see the parade may have been responsible for God taking her. King jumped out of the second story window at his home, but again survived an attempt to kill himself. His father instructed him in his bedroom that King shouldn't blame himself for her death, and that she had been called home to go God as a part of the God's plan, which could not be changed. King struggled with this and could not fully believe that his parents knew where his grandmother had gone. Shortly thereafter, King's father decided to move the family to a two-story brick home on a hill that overlooked downtown Atlanta. In his adolescent years, he initially felt resentment against whites due to the racial humiliation that he, his family, and his neighbors often had to endure in the segregated South. In 1942, when King was 13 years old, he became the youngest assistant manager of the newspaper delivery station for Atlanta Journal. That year, King skipped the ninth grade and was enrolled in a Booker T. Washington High School. The high school was the only in the city for African American students. It had been formed after local black leaders, including King's grandfather, urged the city government of the Atlanta to create it. King became known for his public speaking ability and was part of the school debates team. During his junior year, he won first prize in an oratorial contest sponsored by the Negroes Elks Clubs in the Dublin, Georgia. In his speech, he stated, "Black Americans still will wearing chains, and finest Negroes is at the mercy of the meanest white man." On the ride home to Atlanta by bus, he and his teacher were ordered by the driver to stand so that white passenger could sit down. King initially refused, but complied after his teacher told him that he would be breaking the law if he did not submit. During this incident, King said that he was the angriest I have ever been in my life. King was initially skeptical of many Christianity claimed. At the age of 13, he denied the bodily resurrection of Jesus during Sunday school. At this point, he stated doubts began to spring forth unrelentingly. He concurrently found himself unable to identify with the emotional display and gesture people would make at his church, and started to wonder if he would ever attain personal satisfaction from religion. Morehouse College. During King's junior year in his high school, Morehouse College, a respected historical black college, announced that it would accept any high school junior who could pass its entrance exam. At that time, many students had abandoned further studies to early enlist in World War II. Due to this, Morehouse was eager to fill its classroom. At the age of 15, King passed the exam and entered Morehouse. He played freshman football there the summer before his last year at Morehouse. In 1947, the 18-year-old King chose to enter the ministry. He had concluded that the church offered the most assuring way to answer an inner urge to serve humanity. King's inner urge had begun developing and had and made peace with the Baptist church, as believed he would be a rational minister with the sermons that were respectful force for ideas, even social protest. In 1948, King graduated at the age of 19 from Morehouse with a BA in sociology.